Aha! Aha! Woohoo! Thank you. It's the nicest in fall in Bee Hill City. Especially if you just won the most prestigious gardening competition. I couldn't have won without Granny Veronica's and Freddie's help. It was quite odd that Granny missed the celebration. I couldn't really see where she had gone. Everybody was celebrating our victory, except Jennifer Kane, of course. But as we didn't have any evidence against her, we didn't announce it to the crowd that she was behind those sabotage attempts. Certainly, she wasn't happy. Nevertheless, she was given the second prize cup. Old Tom Kane was fond of his farm, and he wanted to leave it to someone who would take care of it the same way he did, saving its natural beauty. The relationship between Old Tom and Jennifer was spoiled when Jennifer had test holes made in secret because Old Tom objected to all that. Jennifer wanted to sell the farm to a mineral water manufacturer. A bottler factory would have been built there. Old Tom didn't like it very much. So when I won the competition and got his farm as an award, he told me the entire story with relief. Freddie and I set off walking home on the seashore. The air was vibrating all around us. It was curious. And as I was watching him smile, I was sure he could feel the same sparks between us. Our walk didn't last long, because suddenly we could see Granny running down the path towards us. She was shouting something.
Fiona! 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 Your father is alive! She cried loudly.
He was found by fishermen in Peru on the night of the accident, to the north of where his ship had been found. He had just started recovering from his amnesia, and that's why he hadn't been able to send any messages so far. Yes, it was a beautiful fall. On board, flying to Peru, I had a wonderful feeling in my mind. It was the nicest year of my life.